newest plan, Audible. Thank you so much for joining me. I've done some antique shopping recently that I'm very excited about. Both some things for home decor and video props. I want to do a 1920s librarian video. So I picked up lots and lots of interesting old books. But the first thing that I want to show you. I've never seen anything like this before. These were actually a Valentine's Day gift. So these are little medicine boxes. Couldn't find a specific date on these, but they definitely look like something from about 100 years ago. So let's see what ailments we can cure with this handheld pharmacy. Do you by any chance have tonsillitis? Do you have tonsillitis at the moment? Because we can fix you right up right here, right now. Average contents, 135 pellets. This design on the front has a lovely, lovely naked lady with a lovely, lovely lion. I can't tell if she is cuddling or strangling him. Come on, please. Is this little corked bottle. And the pills look like, I think they kind of look like babies, like little baby gun bullets. Baby gun bullets. Isn't this the most gorgeous bottle? I love the color of it and the shape of it. And these indentations here. And it says on it, Celebrated Remedy. Celebrated Remedy. Entirely enveloped in this leather, I guess, sort of material. And here at the bottom, it says, made in Italy. Made in Italy. But I wonder when. I wish absolutely everything could have a date with it. Love these little details. These little details here. That book feel good, doesn't it? Neat, kind of bark-like texture all over it that I think was maybe created by, like, the wood burning, you know, really hot metal tool you can kind of use to carve and burn designs into the wood. It's got this flower headpiece, curly hair framing her face. Swirling down here, lovely profile, lips, nose, eyes, symbol here, jewelry. Latch that, open it up to reveal a silky blue interior lining to keep whatever trinkets you'd like to put inside safe and comfortable. Any little jewelry or brooches, anything like that. Believe how heavy this thing is. This trick pony. This is big here. Ideally a quarter, but the best I could find, it's a dime. You feed it to the horse, and you pull this lever on the back. And he drops it right in there for you, for your savings. So, I like the way this looks. It reminds me of riding carousels as a kid. Just think it's a neat, neat little home decor. had the chance to look through this book too much yet, but I'm really excited to, because the entire thing is a compilation of every monthly release of Good Housekeeping from the year 1908, and that's just exactly the kind of like mundane slice of life stuff. Really fun to see from a long time ago. So fun to look at these covers, see the hairstyles and outfits and jewelry of the time. So this is full of everything from cooking recipes to poetry, short stories, advice columns, advertisements. News, sewing patterns. Oh, so they've got these menus of what recipes you should make for breakfast, lunch, and dinner each day of the week. So let's see, for Monday, breakfast is fruit. Lunch is creamed baked potatoes, applesauce, and cookies. Dinner is chicken casserole, scalloped tomatoes, chocolate Renee, custard, and wafers. It's, this is so heavy. It's kind of awkward to try to show it to you this way, but if you guys are really interested in it, I would love to do one of those videos where you just kind of have an overhead view. Like just this, and my hands like tracing and whispering and kind of just like going through all of this more thoroughly. If you were a flower, a face washing song. There's stuff like this and feeling such like relatable connections to people from over 100 years ago. Happy family. Got a duck, a chicken, and a mouse. And I love this frame of the little lily pads. Happy family by Emma C. Dowd. A little white hen, a duck, and a mouse. Together they live. In a little white house, the mouse went into the market on dark, dark nights, and they ate cake and cheese with keen appetites. They ate cheese and cake till the mouse broke his leg. Then the little white hen laid a little white egg. The duck took them sailing when 'twas fine weather, and so they lived happily, all three together. February fashion ideas. Gray crepe de chine, silver spangled lace, and gray velvet ribbon. Bolero and sleeves formed with rows of ribbon, showing silver tissue underneath. Tucker of gray tulle, girdle of silver tissue. Reception gown for elderly woman. Black net over pastel blue taffeta. Jacket and skirt trimmings, of course, black filet lace, heavily embroidered in shades of pastel blue and silver, embroidered with black velvet ribbon. Blouse of cream chiffon. Got this big, tutorial pamphlet, How to Draw and Paint. What? F-L-O-W-E-R. Yes. Flowers, flowers, flowers. It's $1. And I think I would maybe like to try to make a flower painting using one of these. Not sure which one. Like these yellow roses, these look nice. The yellow roses give you a subject colorful but not too hard. It will take thought. And a good drawing. If using watercolor, use waterproof India ink for the background. Then you can use color over it without it running. Leave white paper if you can. If not, use white opaque for highlights. These roses were painted in watercolors on illustration board. You can do them in oils on canvas board or try plastic colors on canvas or illustration board. Do not be afraid to try, since that is the real way to learn. The New Garden Encyclopedia. Illustrated. The inside cover's really nice. Picturesque cottage scene. Lovely garden. Lupines. Lots of other blooms. Bird baths. Tree. The clouds. The encyclopedia was made in a snap and a camp revised. The aim of presenting its practical, interesting, and helpful from the information and all the abilities and with the garden. Thank you so much for joining me.